Everybody, in today's video, I'm going to share with you how you can use items from the Dollar Tree, or maybe even items you already have at home, to make garland or ornaments for your Christmas tree to make your tree smell like a tree. So even if you have a real live tree, sometimes they don't smell as tree-like as we would envision they should. So we can actually make ornaments to hold the scent of a tree inside that tree and make it feel super duper Christmas overload. Really, really easy. Let's go check it out. So for any of this to be essential oil scented, we have to make a spray. So this is a 2 ounce amber spray bottle. I just got it from Amazon, I'll link it below, filled with water, and then you just add whatever oils you want in there. So some options could be Stress Away, smells amazing, Evergreen Essence, or any of the tree smells like pine, or Idaho Balsam Fir, Idaho Blue Spruce, Northern Lights, Black Spruce, any of these tree oils. There's a whole tree in there, so it's gonna make your tree smell like a real tree. Christmas Spirit is another really good option, or clove, nutmeg, and orange could be a great option too. So in any case, you want to do about 15 to 20 drops of your essential oil into your sprayer bottle there, and then all you're going to do is spray that on the fabric surfaces that we're going to share about right now. So the easiest way of doing this is to grab a tree skirt and just spray the essential oils on the tree skirt. So this is a Dollar Tree tree skirt. You could just spray your essential oils right on there. Easy peasy, super fast. Or the glittered drape is another option if you want it to look like snow. Just spray right on there. But when you put your tree skirt on, all you have to do is spray your oils on there, and that will hold the scent, and you don't have to make any of these things. So this next thing is a pom-pom garland. So I just took a mending kit from the Dollar Tree and threaded the needle that was inside there with some red thread. And you'll want the thread to be as long as you want your garland to be. So for demonstration purposes, I'm obviously not making an entire tree's worth of garland. This is just enough for you guys to see how it's done. Tie a knot at the end and kind of wind it up a little bit so it's a little bit of a thicker knot, and then just start threading your pom-poms onto that thread. And this is 100% Dollar Tree stuff, so super duper inexpensive. And I just alternated the colors, and then I had some pom-poms that were glittery, so I added some glittery ones, and then I just went back and forth. So nothing fancy. There was no like real method to this. Kind of like you were making popcorn garland way back in the day. So then when you're done, you just want to knot the thread around the last pom-pom and cut off the excess, and there you go. So pretend it's long enough to go around your entire tree. It's pretty cute though, right? So then you just want to drape it around your tree. And then once you have it up there, you're just going to spray that with your essential oils. Now, the common question is, how long are these oils going to last? Just kind of depends. I like to spray mine every few days whenever I think about it. So there we go, easy as that. So the next option is using yarn. We're gonna make more different types of pom-pom garland using yarn. So for this, all I do is I wrap the yarn around three fingers many times. And then when I get to the end of however much, I don't know, you just kind of eyeball it, I make sure I cut a long tail of yarn and then hold on to the end so it doesn't unravel. So now I'm just going to take that piece of yarn that I put that I just cut, and I'm going to tie it around the middle of this bundle of yarn. So I want to stick it between my fingers, and I couldn't get it in there because I wrapped my fingers too tight, so I had to grab some scissors to stick it in there too. But basically you're just going to tie it around the center so that your pom-pom doesn't come undone. And you just want to easy, like just get it right off of your fingers, just pull it off. Super simple. You don't want it to like unravel. And then tie a knot in the middle super duper tight. Double knot it just in case because you don't want it coming undone. So now you're just going to take your scissors and cut through the loops that you just made. And if you want, you can make your pom-pom look super dense and fluffy if you really give it a good haircut when you're done cutting through these loops, or you can leave it kind of shaggy like I did. Now I did cut off some of the pieces that were a little bit longer, but I kept intact, you can see I'm holding on to it there, the wrap that I held the entire pom-pom together with. So I'm keeping those ends, but I'm cutting off all the other little things that are sticking up all over the place.
kind of looks like a koosh ball for those of you that are in the 90s. So then after that, I just made a whole bunch of them, different sizes. So the smaller ones, I wrapped them around 2 fingers. Larger sizes, I wrapped them around 4 fingers, but nothing super fancy. And then I took those long ends and just started tying it to a long piece of yarn. Again, as long as you want it to wrap around your Christmas tree. So I'm just gonna tie all of them on here, and I kind of alternated sizes. So I did a big one, and then a small one, then a medium size one, and then back to a big one. You know, you could do whatever you wanted to do. Do different colors of yarn. You know, it just kind of depends on what your color scheme is. I liked the white because I thought it looked like snowballs. I don't know. So then I just went around and cut off those ends that I tied the pom-poms to the longer pieces of yarn with. And there we go. There is our yarn garland. Aren't they cute? They kind of look like snowballs. I just think it's adorable. So again, same type of thing. You just spray those down with your essential oils and your tree will smell like a Christmas tree. It's super awesome. So if you guys are interested in learning more about essential oils, how to use them to support your health and your family's health and have tools at home for all the things, I've got a class coming up on Facebook November the 19th from 7 p.m. to 8 p.m. Eastern time. You guys are welcome to come if you are in my essential oil family or not yet oily. I hope to see you there.
Thank you guys so much for hanging out with me today. If you haven't already and you'd like to, hit that button down below, subscribe so you never miss a daily video. Happy diffuser making. I'll see you all tomorrow. Ciao.